This is Carrick Williams, Carrick Williams Photography, LLC, 811 Hickory Glen Drive, Sefner, Florida, 33584. Today's date is Wednesday, September 30th. Our client today is Wharton Smith Incorporated, 4912 West LaSalle Street, Tampa, Florida, 33607. The telephone number is 813-288-0068. The project engineer and main contact for Wharton Smith is Mr. Scott Griffith. The project manager is Mr. Pedro Rivera with Hillsborough County Public Utilities Department. The Hillsborough County project bid number is ITBC00450215ST. The project number is 15-020 Belrico AWTP UV system recirculation pumps. It's the expansion of the existing Trojan UV 3000 plus UV disinfection system at the Belrico AWTP. This project location is Hillsborough County Public Utilities Department, Belrico Wastewater Treatment Plant at 1167 North Dover Road, Dover, Florida, 33527. We're going to start our survey off with a round circumference view of the entire work area. We're going to start at the filter building 5 through 8. We are facing north. We're traveling north, facing west. And this is the start of our project. We're going to make a quick run around the entire circumference of the project area. Okay, so we're ready. Again, we're facing, traveling north. We're going in a complete circle just to show an overview of the entire area. The UV disinfection system is where the work will be taking place. To my left is a green 36-inch line, which they'll be tying into, Wharton Smith will be tying into. A little bit faster. As we're going around the corner, we're now starting to turn to the west. We're going by electrical building number 3. Give an overview of that building. The camera is now facing south. We're traveling west, looking at a 36-inch line. That 36-inch line will be downgraded to about a 30-inch line, which then looks like it goes down to about a 24-inch line. We'll be recording all this in detail shortly. We're looking at the chlorination blower building. We'll travel around that. We'll be going inside there, room in that location also. Again, this is the backside. We're now traveling south. I'm looking back east at the chlorination blower building and the electrical building number 4. We'll be inside the electrical building shortly. This video also is showing the grass area, the condition of it as we go around, which may be a staging area. We're coming up to and about to pass filter building 1 through 4. We're headed southeast, looking back toward the northeast. We will not be, they will not be working in this area, but we want to still get a good view of it. This is the intermediate pump station. And as you can see in the far distance, the south side of the filters 5 through 8. We're now heading back north, about to complete the circle. Again, we're traveling north, facing west. Coming back to the east side of the filters 5 through 8. We're gonna stop about right here, and the rest of the video will be on foot. We're gonna start off with the electrical building number 3. We are on the north side of the electrical building. We're facing south. This is the front entrance. We're facing south. We're looking at the north side of electrical building number 3. We're going to go inside and view the electrical room. Okay, we're going to start electrical building number 3 from the outside going inside. We're going south to the left entrance. As we come in, we can see the safety cabinet. We're going to start and go to our left. We're showing the screen. The box number is PLCE3. That box shows to be nice and new looking. No damages. We get a view of the wall and ceiling. Looks to be a fairly new and clean building. Panning down to the floor. There's some minor chips, some minor paint splatters, but no major problems. Looking at the square D box. Transformer box LE3. Again, we're going in the door and going to our left. We're now going to look at the breaker boxes. I'm going to make a special note as I step back to get a better view that there is ample space on the ground. A pad with a stainless steel top on it. There's nothing there. Again, it looks to be in good condition. Going to our left. Again, around the circle. This is an access entry door. E412245. Gonna pan back out. Continue to our left. Again, for reference, we came in the door to my right now. Walked across. It shows two rows of breaker boxes. Fire extinguisher on the wall in good condition. Electrical outlet. Whoa. From the condition of the breaker boxes. In front of us here, we have another breaker box to my left. That is the filtration system main control panel. Breaker box in back. AHU-5 FED from MCC-9. We've got two big air conditioners, looks like recirculating air conditioning units. I'm going to turn back around and look where we just came in and continue around the panels. We're going to now come around between these two panels and look at the panel on my right side, which I believe is the east side. I'm going to start with panel number MCC8H7. I'm going to close a few of that. The main breaker. The panel number is right here. On the floor area, this is the entire unit number is MCC-8. It does show some loose screws, nuts, and a lock washer, the bottom of that first panel. I'm going to turn around and go back the way we just came, looking at the other panel box. This is the entire set here. Number is MCC-10. We continue to go around, noticing a breaker, an outlet. I'm noticing a crack, a stair step crack. Just left of that PLNL E3 circuit number 9. There's a stair step crack going up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It's like 5 blocks high. Right from the floor, going up. Looking at another breaker for the AC, it looks like. That breaker is AHU-6, fed from MCC-9. We're now going to look at this last breaker on the way out. Turn all the controls. Everything is on. The base looks good. I'm going to turn around and get a reverse view of that same area. This breaker, set of breakers, is MCC-11. It's directly across from the UPS room, which we will not be going into. That concludes the interior of the electrical building number 3. We are now going into the other electrical room in the chlorination blower building. We're going to start getting a wide view of the chlorination blower building. I'm on the west side of the building, facing east. We're going into the electrical building, number 4, to view the panels in that building. We're getting a little bit closer view of the electrical building, number 4, entrance door. This is the door on the west side of the building. We are now facing east, looking at the west side of the building. This door shows sun damage. It shows the signage and nomenclature on the door is washed out. The left sign, I believe, says high voltage, keep out. The right red sign probably says no smoking. And the bottom sign is the electrical room information. Again, looking at this, there's no apparent damage to the doorway or sidewalk. We're going to take a quick look across the sideway. To the left, which is north of this doorway, there is a set of valves. Those valves are encased in concrete. On the north corner of that concrete, it shows where that slab has been broken. The entire corner is broken in two pieces. This is the same view of the same area. I'm now facing south. The sidewalk area going to the doorway is in good condition. Looking to the left, which is north, going across to the right, which is south, going to the doorway. We're gonna start walking into the doorway. Again, we're on the west side of the building, facing east, traveling into the building. As we come in, we're gonna start off to our left and turn. We get a wide view. Kind of noisy in here. I just cut off. Good. As we go forward, we're going to show, we're going to pass by a breaker box. We get an overview of the entire room from the wall. Come in the door, looking to my right. On the safety cabinet, getting an entire view from the front door. We're gonna head to the left. There's a safety fire extinguisher. There's a pad below. The doorway, this area's been, has some mortar on it, but it doesn't look like a repair. Just showing the condition of the mortar. All around and including the bottom on that pad. There's a second door. That door is boarded up. Not boarded up, it's hurricane protection is there. It's a glass door, you can see through it. Again, as we go ahead, we're gonna see the air conditioning units from the base to the top. This is air conditioning unit number 10, E412266. I'm gonna go back and look the other way across the room. The door's on my right. is the second air conditioning unit. So that's 72 degrees. This unit is number E412258. All you can see on to my right is the backside of these breaker boxes. There's nothing to see. There's no damage or debris. It does show the pad has some chipped areas, or where I guess it oozed out from under the form and it was poured. But there's no damage. Looking to my right, we walk around, we'll see breaker box number PM6142 and PM641 from the base to the top. As we go around, looking at more switches from the bottom. Switch number PM9302, PM9303, PM9304, and the last one doesn't have any label on it. Everything looks to be in good shape. Relatively new looking, clean, no damage. I'm looking at a door. Also, it's an exit door. If you go around, the pad, again, the concrete's mortar's been patched. I want to also make a special note as I go around that the window shows damage on a screen. That's a screen. The top part has got a indentation on it where it's been bent, and the next part is boarded up. You can see where it's been boarded up less than halfway to the top. We're going to finish this by going back around between these two breaker boxes. This breaker box says MCC-1 chlorine building in front of me. As I turn to my right, going back toward the door, you can see safety rugs, mats down in place. We're going to look first to our right. Go back toward the door entrance. We're going to turn around, go back down the same aisle. Looking at both the floor and the tops. And we're going to squeeze by and squeeze through ahead of us, the entrance door we came in. We're going to turn around. Get a view of this box, RASL pump number 3, VFD. It says PM9349. To our right, the filter main control panel. There's some wiring box, small bolts and nuts and screws at the very base. Piece of metal. Laying against the wall in the back. This wall also shows the closer view here, shows the concrete kind of coming away from, like stucco, kind of coming away from the block. Not really damaged, it's just stucco's coming off. As we back out, we'll look to my left, the breaker boxes. Again, we're back at the front door entrance, making our way back out. And this concludes recording of the electrical building number 4. We're going to start back now on the exterior of the site. As a reference, reviewing filter building for 5 through 8. I'm on the east side of the project area. I'm gonna pan around and face west. And just ahead is where we're gonna start the video survey. We're now facing west, looking at a large 36-inch green line just south of that, showing some controls. The area is encased in rocks. The sidewalk area is in good repair. We're traveling north. I'm going to turn back and face the same line. Look around this line. This line is where the Wharton Smith's going to tie in. So we're looking at the entire area. I'm going to look down here, where this line is tied in at the very bottom, and the valve. I'm gonna back out. We're gonna head north. And go around the first part of the outside of the UV disinfection system. Showing the exterior wall. Aluminum boxes, welded. For the entire wall area. To our right is the electrical building that we recorded earlier. This is the back side of it. This is the south side of that building where the AC units are. We're going to look at these AC units just to make sure. It does show on the pad on the bottom here, on the north pad, the south west corner. It's broken, chipped, pieces chipped off of that corner. We're traveling east, looking to the north, again with the south side of the electrical building. Number 3, I believe. Okay. We're going to head back to the disinfection system. As we head north, taking note of the sidewalks in good condition. Approaching the stairwell. Noting that the area below There's a drain and it has been holding water. There's mildew. I'm gonna go up these stairs, noting at the very bottom of the stairs, there looks to be a break. At the very bottom of the step, concrete is chipped away. And this is the steps going up to the platform, the UV disinfection system on the west side. As we go up the steps, seem to be in good condition, handrails in good condition. We're going to start to our right, which is north, and travel north. First thing we come to, well, those stairs we come to is it's a transducer, EPS level LIT1002PLC-3. As we continue to head north, we're seeing the 110 outlets. Again, back to 36-inch line. There's a hose connection. The line seems to be in good, appears to be in good condition. There's a pad directly in front of me. Again, we're facing and traveling north. Noticing the condition of the 36-inch line. And all the piping coming to and from it. This line comes down here and goes back toward the south and then goes into the ground to the platform. As we continue, we're now at the northeast corner. We're going to turn left and start facing west. We're seeing instrument panels. The first one for the condition of the grating, condition of the valves. Condition of the pad with a pump sitting on. I'm going to step back and get a wider view. As we come back in, we're going to notice where the pump sits on top of the pad. There are some minor cracks in the foundation. This is on the south side. I'm going to round it to my left, which is the west side. Again, another angle of the entire pump and line. Instrument panel, we're now facing north. Taking a look also at the grating. We're now facing northeast, northwest. And now west, this is the second pump. Taking note of the base pad. The area shows no signs of leaks. This was EPS pump number 4, MCC-8. We're gonna come back. We're gonna also take note to the west of this second pump. There's a light, the 110 circuit in the bottom. We continue to head west. Let me go back and give you an overview. When you first came in, there's a empty pad. Then there's a pad with a pump on it. Another empty pad. And now we look at the second pump. After that, there's another pad. We're heading west, facing north, panning around to our west. We're gonna go around the second pump on the west side of it. Again, taking note of the base. Showing some minor cracks at the very bottom. Showing all the valves. We're heading north around this pump, looking at the west side of it. Little green lizard. Looking at this big, like a 24-inch check valve. Check valve number, 20-inch. EP number 5, effluent pump pad. We're now looking directly north, noting the breaker boxes, excuse me, and the grating. We turn toward the west again, noting the next breaker box. Again, the pad and the grating. We're also looking at the south side of that 36-inch line also. We're now looking directly west. Again, another light pole here. Looking at the base of it. Top of it. Looking at the east side of the third pump and pad area. It does show some minor cracks, the base. This is EPS pump number 3. MCC-9. I'm going to back up. Give you a full view of the third pump going from east to west. I'm gonna go around that pump and go to the fourth and last pump. Again, noting the pad area. Again, this at the base here on the southwest corner, concrete is broken. Backside of the pump. So on the base, I'm gonna swing around. We're facing east, looking at the west side of the line. Check valve 20 inch, E412291. Noting the south side of the line. Noticing a valve, breaker box, again, all in good condition. Breaker box says EP-1, feed from MCC-9. And now we're facing west, looking at the final 20 inch line going down into this final pump, which is the far west pump. Again, noting the condition of the concrete slab, the base of the pump. Again, showing some minor cracks. This pump base also has a repair at the southwest corner. I'm going to go around and again look at this pump. Looking at the base, it's about a 4-inch line coming here going into the structure. Again, showing 20-inch check valve, number E412293. Now, on this last line, it looks to be that the valve up top is leaking. This last valve, looking at the southwest corner, shows that it's leaking oil. Down onto the pipe itself, then down itself, down into the grating. As we head back, heading back south, we're going to stay on the platform first. No, we're not. We're going to take a right and go down . Let me give you a view of where we are. We came in on the east side of the building, side of the platform. We walked around, past all the pumps, to the fourth pump here. And now we're gonna go to our left, which is west, down the stairwell steps to the next area. We'll come back and get the other side of the platform in just a minute. As we go down, only the handrails look good. We're gonna go down and then notice, holding the handrail of course, we're gonna notice and turn around and face the pad. Steps, again, all look in good condition. Handrail. We're going to start back at the steps. We're going to go straight ahead, showing some valves. To turn to the left, which is south, and start noting the valves on a platform, on a pad. Let's get a wider view of that. We're traveling south. I'm now looking east at the valves. Sodium hypo. SHFP number 4, SHCP. Again, getting an overall view. These pumps, they show no signs of leaks. Again, we're traveling south. Next to this is a very large tank, probably 15 feet tall or so, from the base up to the top. From the walkway. We're now gonna turn around back to the northeast, use the same tank where we just came from, showing the safety ladder going up. We're gonna also look back over our shoulder here and look up at the roof. You can see it's be in good condition. And come back down over the same tank. I'm going to step back and go around the second tank. From the base of the tank, the lines in the back, we're going to walk around that way in just a second. I'm still traveling south. There's a cutout here with a valve in it. The area is holding water. There's a third pad with nothing on it at all. It's just blank for future use. We're now going to turn from the south, turn around to the east. Go back around, get a better view here. Go back around and look back to the north. The tanks. Walk behind the tanks. Again, there's no leakage, no spills, just some water or wet area, I don't know what it is, underneath this valve. The valve is closed and does not show leaking, but the inside of the valve does show wet, so get real close here. The inside does show a little wet, so maybe it did come from there. There's a second puddle few feet away. Again, I'm heading north on the back side of the tanks. And now we're on the back side of, we came on a stairwell there. This is the east side of that more pumps. These are sodium hypo S. Let's get a better view of that. SHFP number 1, number 2, number 3. Get a wide view of all of this area, starting from south going north. And there's no smell, There's no leaks. There is some moisture down here. I believe it's water. I can't tell. Under the steps. And this is pump number three. Again, looking back at it, there's no leaks. Just correct that. On the right side, which is the north side, there does show that something has spilled out. This is the northeast side under these pumps. Something did spill out, but it seems to be dry now. But if you look down, you'll see where it looks like it spilled, ran down, and then ran toward the west. That drain in the far west corner. We're going to head back up the steps. We're going to take a quick view just down this walkway here to the south. Going to the concrete pad, looking down the entire walkway. It does show a couple of hoses on the ground. Other than that, it does looks pretty clear. We're now gonna walk around the entire covered area, get a wide shot of this. We're viewing south now. We're gonna walk, showing the cover plates, showing the handrails in good condition. We're now facing west. We're going to turn back to the right, which is south. Noting condition of the handrails, which is in good condition, and head down these steps, holding them, of course. We're going to stop at the bottom of the steps, show where we were. The condition of the steps have some mildew, but there's no damage, no major corrosion. And we're now looking north at those steps. We're gonna pan around to the west and note the handrail area. Note the flooring, the metal flooring. I believe it's aluminum. This at the, we're at the fecal sample point, number one. We're going to get a view of the overview of what's down below. So in the wall area. Now, we're now looking at the, we're now looking at the back side of the actual filters. Let me change out. I'm now facing south. I'm gonna zoom in. This is the far south filter. This is the middle filter, backside. It's the back side of the first filter. We started from the south and went north. We're going to now watch our step here and go around. Let's go around this way. Back to the north, back to the east. We're now probably almost 3 feet down into the sub-platform. This is the UV channel number one. We're now going to view from the north going to the south, the east side of the first filter, going from north to south. Put in the handrail area in the back. This is now the second filter, the middle filter. Again, going to the south. This says UV channel one. UV channel one. We're gonna back out. We're at the south side of the platform. You know, the handrail area, the decking area, the concrete wall area. There are breaker boxes up here. Again, this is the south side. Turn around and face north. Right from the base to the top of the Trojan UV 3000 Plus system. We're now going to step to the right, which is east, and look at the south side. There's some steps and handrail. For the south side, another set of filters. This says it says bank number one, B. Across from bank number one, B, your wide view, that third filter, what it says, UV channel one, is bank 1C. So again, we're heading back north. Looking at the second filter, the wall around it, the decking, the handrails, it's all look good. Disconnect breaker box. We're going to stop and look back here to the south and notice this gantry crane up here. This crane is to the south. And it stops here in the middle. There's a second crane to the north, right next to this second filter, the north filter on the east side. We We're now heading back north. Again, noting the handrails, decking, all looks good. This blue valve looks good. We go back to the stairwell, the steps to the north. This at the top of the steps, there is a patched area at the very tip of the step. There's a crack. There's two cracks running from south to north from the steps up to the like an access plate. Let's get it from this side. Again, you can see the repair. Like a rust stain, something spilled. Those two cracks going from south to north. They meet a repair that's been cracked also. And there's a long crack, actually, now that I'm up here. This crack runs all the way from the west access plate, running east. Quite a ways down. No major damage, just showing the cracks in the concrete. For the repair here between pump 3 and 4 facing north. Showing a repair here on the east side of pump 3. We'll look back to the west as we travel east and look at the safety eyewash station, hand washing station, water hose. Water hose has a bad area at the end of it. We're now going to face back to the south and head to the south between the west set of UV filters and the east UV filters. Heading south. Again, there's no breaks or tears or cracks in the concrete. The handrails on both sides look good. Take a quick pause here. You're facing south. Okay, we're at the south end of the platform. We're going to turn back to the east, go down the steps, and record the east set of filters. We're going to look back toward the west. Look at the base of the steps. Handrails. Looking south. At the wall. Looking at the breaker boxes. We're still facing east now. We are now, this says UV channel 2. This is the far south set of panels, UV filters. This set of filters is already hooked up to the crane. It just shows slack in the line has not been picked up. As we head back to the north, we're looking at the right side, which is the east side panels. This is the one panel farthest to the south. The plate says Bank 2C. We're heading north. We're now going to the middle set of panels, noting the handrail area, the panels themselves, and the walkway around the panels. Here's the breaker box for lift crane 3. I'm going to turn back to the south and note the crane that's attached to the panel already. It's a south crane on the east side. Turn back around facing north. Continuing north, we're now going to look at the east side panels, the third one, the first one to the north. We're going to walk around to our right, which is north. This says fecal sample point number 2 as a reference point where we are right now. Under the handrail, noting there's a piece of PVC pipe that's detached, looks to be broken off in the southwest corner. Facing back around to the north, turning around toward the west, we're going to go back, look at these two other panels, turning back from west to south. There's two more panels on the right side. The first panel says Bank 2A. Again, only the handrails, the panels themselves, the front side of the crane. And we're going to go around to the second and last panel in this east section. The first one right next to the steps we came down at. We're facing south. We're going to go back up the ramp steps, turn back around to the north, and proceed north off the deck. This is actually a flow meter. I didn't mention there's a table down here. It's a water-soaked table on that bottom deck down there. We're heading north. We're gonna look to the east. And this is the UV disinfection control panel. We're going to turn toward the east, and exit the platform. I'm gonna stop back here and get a wide view. Again, facing south, a wide view of the east side of the filtration system. Okay, we're gonna continue east here and head back down the steps. We're gonna turn to the north and face north. We're now between the platform we just left to the west and the electrical building to the right, which we videoed the interior of earlier. We're gonna head north, taking note of the platform area, the 36 inch pipe, sidewalk. This sidewalk shows a scar. I'm gonna call it a scar. It's not a break, it's a scar, but it's not bad. The surrounding area next to the electrical building looks good. The sidewalk looks good. The walls look good. But again, we're looking at the supports as well as the line itself. We're looking at the west side looking at the east side of the line. Again, looking at the support area, support pad. We're turning now, walking toward the west, but we're actually looking south now. And again, this 36 inch line, the supports around it, the pad around it. Again, we're walking to the west and looking at the south side. We're facing south, looking at the line, the valves, the pad. It's an electrical manhole. The line shows this reduction line. It goes from 36 to probably 30. Then it goes down, it reduced again down to like 24. You know, I've seen no real issues with cracks or damage. For reference, we're going to look back around, and this is again the northwest corner. And this is where that valve was leaking up top. To better view it from down here, you can see where it was leaking oil. We're going to continue around the building. We're going to go now, we're still facing south, we're traveling west, and this is the outside area where we stepped down from the platform into the area where the tanks and small pumps were. This is the outside of that. I'm facing south. This is the sodium hydrochloric control panel, eyewash station, and controls. Again, everything shows nice and clean. There's no breakage from what I can see, no damage. There is, however, where the pad meets the the next sidewalk, it does show some separation in the weather stripping or expansion joint. But again, it's not bad at all. We're now going to walk again around the outside. The same area, you're getting the same view from a farther away station, a far away angle. Again, this is a sodium hydrochloride fill station only sign. That sign is next to the eyewash station. We're now going to be heading south. We're heading south between a area to the right, which is west, which has the bulldozer inside. It's a walkway only. We again see the to the left, which is east, the two pumps, the large tanks. Just for reference sake, we're again across from those tanks. Use a transducer level bleach tank number one and the sodium hypo tank number one, LIT1201 SHFP. You can see the second tank just in this walkway between the tanks and the next building. For reference sake also, we'll look to our, well, let's look to our left first and show this. Look to our right here and show this room is the electrical room that we videoed earlier. This is the different, this is the back entrance. As you note, this is the entrance where to the south there is that window that was boarded up. The window to the north is half covered with the hurricane protection. Well, the door also is covered with hurricane protection. The door is worn, the signs are worn, but you can see them a lot better. They're not sun damaged. But again, you can see the where that window glass is broken and replaced with plywood. We're gonna walk around. We're traveling south still. We're gonna look to our right. We're gonna go in there and look to our right and see some other pumps, and we're not gonna enter that area at all, just for reference sake. Looking back to our south, turning around to the west, noting we're now facing east, looking back at the covered area where the filters are, UV filters. We'll step back and look to our north. Get a wide view of the tanks and the UV areas where the filters are, covered areas. Again, this is the area where the actual work will be performed. Again, looking north, panning from north to east, looking at a wide view of the work site. We're now looking directly east between the actual work site to the north and another area to the south. We're gonna walk through and note the sidewalk area. Before I do that, let's look back here just for a second. At the corner, almost a corner of looking north, there is a break in the sidewalk. Let me get a little closer for that. There's a crack right about there, running from east to west. This is the second sidewalk section going from south to north. We're now going to walk to the east, look back to the north, and note the exterior of the wall, noting another set of steps going up to the platform area. We're again traveling east, looking north, taking special note of the sidewalk, the steps, the wall, all piping and electrical in the area. We're heading east again. We're going to stop here, turn from east to south to southwest where we first started, 36-inch line where the tie-in will be. We're going to start back here at the southeast corner and look at the storage laydown area showing the grass, showing the terrain, what's here and what's not here. There's some bare areas. Again, we're right next to where it says filters 5 through 8. We're like right below that area. There is some area that looks like it's been damaged and been cleared with rock. And we're now looking north. In front of us is the electrical building to the north. Again, we're going to start from the east and pan around toward the north. It shows that there's a hill. Terrain rises up across the way by the electrical building. Again, this area here has been patched with gravel, rock, been bare. We're showing the area that's bare around the, like an electric entrance. Okay, again, we're at the very south of the work area. This is gonna be a storage area only. But I wanted to make sure I showed this area to show the grass terrain. What's here, what's not here, there's some bare areas. Of course, this is not a luxury homeowner's lot, so we're gonna have some patched areas. But overall, the only bad area I see is the one back over by that building, just north of that building, right about there, that was somehow damaged and patched with some rock. Again, we're facing north. Looking at the back side of the south side of the electric building. Looking at the work area, the UV disinfection system area. And back to the starting point, those 36-inch lines where the tie-in will be. This concludes our video recording. This is Carrick Williams, Carrick Williams Photography, LLC, Sefner, Florida. Thank you very much.